My name's Adam Fanua Blake. I play for the Mix Eagles and I'm proud to be Tonga. Matthew Matonga!
Gens has this remarkable second 40 and still gets away!
From Fasi and Mofanga. I attended Tupou College Tolo in 2011. It had a massive impact on my life. It taught me how to be grateful, not take things for granted. You know, over here in Australia, we can have hot showers and, you know, and all the stuff like that whenever you want, but in Tonga, there's no hot water and stuff like that. So it just taught me to be really, you know, grateful for what I've got, you know, and count my blessings because, you know, nothing comes easy. So yeah, it was really hard, obviously, you know, to choose Kiwis over Tonga. You know, I spent about a good week thinking about what I should do, but I thought, you know, I never really need to, you know, give both teams a try before, you know, can come to a final decision of where I want to play. You know, and that's what sort of led me to choose the Kiwis. You know, and I had a really good time and I learned you know, a lot of important things off the players there, and you know, I enjoyed my time there playing for.
This is the 2017 Rugby League World Cup.
Very disappointed, you know, that obviously because I was in the Kiwi team, that they lost, the Blues lost, you know, it's not very easy taking any loss, you know, easy, but, you know, especially that one, because, you know, oh, that's my country. But then again, I felt very proud, you know, of the Blues that played for Tonga, and, you know, I was overwhelmed with all the, you know, to see all the support that they, you know, they received from or the Tonga community in New Zealand, and the supporters that flew in from Australia as well. You know, that was probably one of the biggest games I've ever seen. You know, and just the amount of support they all got. You know, it was very joyful to see that our little country, you know, came together as one for that one day. Playing against Samoa this year was definitely one of the toughest games I played in. You know, even though there was a lot of tries scored. You know, it was definitely very physical in the middle. You know, they're a very passionate team as well. You know, they got a little country and they got a lot to fight for, just like us. You know, and hopefully, you know, in the next couple of years, we get to play them again and have good games against them again. I was more emotionally attached to the jersey when I played for Tonga than I was to play for Kiwis. And that's not, I'm not saying that in any sort of disrespectful way to the Kiwis. You know, I'm very, you know, grateful for the opportunity that they gave me, but you know, being a Tongan and sort of seeing all the support that all the Tongan boys got in the World Cup, sort of envied a lot of it. Wolfie gave me a call and asked me if I wanted to play with Tonga again. I really thought hard about it, and you know, at the end of the day, I am Tongan and I am a proud Tongan, and you know, I came to the decision with. I couldn't wait to put the red jersey back on. So, you know, obviously not many people do get to represent the country in the NRL, and if you do, you're lucky. So, you know, you never know when it might be your last time to represent your country, so you might put your best foot forward. And, you know, I'm lucky enough to have done it twice already. You know, and I hope I get to do it in the end of the year against Australia and the big one. But, yeah, man, it means the world to me and to my family. You know, my grandfather, my mother, you know, my father, all of them, I'm pretty sure that they're pretty happy that I'm playing for Tonga again, so yeah.